although it's exciting in every new place, can get a little bit old. So to sort of stave off the drudgery, we came up with this idea of performing a little skit for you guys, which we're going to do now. And it is entitled The Events Leading Up to the Collapse of Detective Delight. So without further ado, please enjoy our wee little pantomime.
There were Jello and the fingerprints, Detective Dolite discovered. This proved to be the most important finding in the case. And whereas Detective Slocks and Slobbit slobbered over smutty photographs,
look at the size of those.
Dolite had a better lead to follow. He followed the ringing to the telephone, where a voice asked,
"Excuse me, are you so-and-so? Oh, so-and-so, since you left, I have been eating only sweets, but they remind me of you."
He felt this surely was a clue, so he climbed into the tub, wearing his underwear and overcoat, jumped aboard the model boat, and followed the water down the drain. In his brain, there are file cabinets and secretaries filing their nails downstairs.
"But I don't want to talk about that room downstairs."
At this moment, Detective Slocks and Slobbits realized that since they had reported on the crime scene this morning, each of them has aged over 50 years. Two butterflies land on their shoulders and harmonize softly in their ears. They held hands in the moonlight. The butterflies flew away, which prompted Slobbits to say,
"It's queer, but I miss them already."
Then Slocks removed a fountain pen from his breast pocket, drove it deeply into Slobbits' throat, and began screeching,
"Dove to the parchment well! The robot in the cell!"
While in prison, Slocks wrote one of the most revered exercises in free verse titled, The Cause of Gauze.
"Oh, the cause of gauze! The Manuels have fondled many memories from my lap, though each memory has its own lap, and swimmers swim laps. Even swimmers have laps, however, and while in that condition, many require a delicate gauze. I desire only this in my decrepitude, that I will have one more opportunity to serve as a gauze for my fellow man, and that in that state of gauze, can somehow disturb the world less often with my prickly fingers."
When Detective Dolite, returning from the catacombs, first heard the news of the Slocks and Slobbits stabbing and subsequent poetry enterprise, he immediately fell to the floor and began plucking peaches from his cheeks. This eventually became a tiresome activity, so he evaporated into the cream afloat a child's bedtime cocoa. Good evening, everybody.
I want to say that.
There was Jello in the fingerprints.
I'm on
you. Thank you.
and friends, Charlie and Freddy. And we hope you enjoy meeting them.
Well, I don't think there's any girl out there like Elizabeth. And even if there were, well, how would I find her? Charlie, all I'm saying is she's nothing special. Well, I see 10 girls a day just like her out there on the thoroughfare. But I don't think there's any girl out there like Elizabeth. And even if there were, well, how would I find her?
Thank you. So this is a new song. Winding procession of cars.
Thank you.
We can do more than just play rock and roll. We're gonna play slow rock.
Yeah.
We can play low rock and roll.
Play
hard
dance.
Rock and slow rock. But this one's off of the EP, The Bird Who Continues to Eat the Rabbit's Flower, which was originally titled The Bird Who Eats the Rabbit's Flower. And it's called If I Falter Slightly Twice, and here it goes.
Thank you.
was a large, white, vibrating egg. That's an Annie Hall reference. Aren't I hip?
Through the whole town to worry if Nicky's in his. They immediately started the search.